fix your heart. Moved to the city in a broke down car and 4 years no calls. Now you're looking pretty in a hotel. Hey guys, it's Kimberly. Welcome to my channel. And I used to see those vloggers, bloggers, how to plan their trips and making an awesome video and photos. And I was thinking,
that's cool.
Oh my gosh, you did that. Cause I've been to so many countries, I didn't do that. But if now I have a free time, I would like to visit new countries, then back to retake those pictures. Finally, I found a solution to make a list. Today I'm gonna to share these useful skills with you. Don't need to worry about do you have a Photoshop basic skill or not. I will show you from the beginning to the end. From remove background to save photo into GIF. Oh, I can't wait to do this. One more thing to say. If you are new, I would like to invite you to join our Travel Fun family. So good! Thank you! And if you guys are already part of our Travel Fun family, I would like to say you guys are awesome! We are family! I would like to give you a French kiss! I love you! So without further ado, let's do it! I took some selfies and each of it has a tiny difference effect. The trick there is you have to stay in the same position. There have some tools can help you out, such as camera grid or some camera has ghost function, and you can always have your own style to doing this. Now we're going to import all these files into Photoshop. First, we need to create a new file. I will rename it to TravelV and send width to 1280 and height 720, which is the size for YouTube video. And set the background to transparent, then click OK. Now we are able to import our first photo. Drag in, then click Enter. Enable to edit layer, we need to resize the layer. Then I'm gonna use quick selection tool. Select white background and zoom in to fix the details. The simple way to do mask is go to menu, select, then invert the selected area. Then click refine edge button. Yeah, I am quite happy with this. Because I checked the remember settings, so it will automatically save my previous preference. So I am happy with all of this. All you need to remember is set up to new layer with layer mask. Cause this it will create a new layer with mask and you can still keep the old layers as a spare. Then click OK. Now it's time to do our background photo. Drag in and resize it. Then press enter. Now you can see our selfie photo. It's because the background picture layers on the top. So just drag it down. Now we are able to see. And now my photo looks a bit pumped out. So I'm gonna do adjustment position in order to make it look more real. And as we can see, there has a white frame which I didn't remove clear. So I have to use select pen tool and make sure the front color is black and select the layer mask. Yeah, now looks all good. Then I'm gonna use blur tool brush the edge, make these two photos look like the one. Later we will use the oldest photo save it into GIF, so I just roughly brush the edge. I don't really do the detail. Now it's the time to adjust our colors. So go to adjustment, choose labels, then send the middle a bit lighter. Once Once I am satisfied with all the colors, I gotta put them into the file, cause we still have many photos need to do. So it's a very good way to sorting all these files.Okay, now we are ready to save this file. File Export Save for Web. In format, we're gonna to select JPEG. Now I done all these photos, and we need to import them back to the Photoshop.Once new file created, I gonna to import the rest. Why we don't import them at once? It's because if we delete the Photoshop, we'll import photos into 11 separate files. That's not what I want, so we won't do that. So now we can drag in the rest of photos, then click Enter to import photos. Then go to Windows, File the Timeline,In here, make sure you select the right one, then click the button. It will automatically create the first photo. Now I gotta go to setting time, how long I would like to switch my photos. I would like to set it to 0.2 seconds. We have 11 photos, so I gotta to click 10 moreTimes to create the new GIF photos. And then we have to manually change each of the pictures. I know, this is a bit bored, but once we see the result, everything's gonna worth it. So guys, just be patient.Here you can decide how many times to run GIF. I would like to set them forever. It looks awesome! All my memories are back! I feel like I've been to these countries once again. It's time to save the file.Export Save for Web. Hey guys, this time we have to select GIF format. And other settings are all good, so I'm gonna to click Save. Make sure the format you choose is image only. Setting default setting. Okay, they are all good.Hey guys, if you are enjoying today's video, don't forget give me a thumbs up and subscribe my channel. And I'll see you guys in next video.